Welcome back to Let's Play A Tear of Vermillion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, now in Guia. Well, we've been in Guia, now heading to the factory. Wow. Let's look around up here before we go down anywhere. We'll get back there. Oh, there's nothing much to see up here then. Wall. Cool. Running into gears. Always a lot of fun. Hello? Oops. What brings you here? Oops. Don't say oops. It's dangerous to get close to the blast furnaces. Yeah, well, the impetuous of youth and all that. We could just walk on the pipes. Hi there. Why are you walking around in here? The factory is off-limit to unauthorized personnel. Obviously, we don't care. We just ignore him and continue on. Oops. Oh, that's a big pipe in the way. It's the same color as the floor. I didn't see it. Alright. Guess we're going down. Looking for our friend. Dead end. I can barely see where I'm going here. Reminds me of Phantasy Star 2 with all the pipes overlaid and the dungeons. This is a lot cooler though. What's back here? Another dead end type area? Oh, it's a door. Cool. Alright. I'm gonna get lost in here. Let's check inside the door. Oh wow. I'm gonna mess with all the little instruments here. Very interesting. Cool. Oh, you found some down here, huh? I can't get what you have. Wait. I can't get to you. There we go. Oh, we got a reblade. Thank you. Oh, okay. You're preventing me from moving. Okay, we can go up or we can go... Really? Okay. Just stop finding things now. This blast furnace is so difficult to operate. Blast it, right? The high output design enhances productivity, but the settings are too complex. Okay. Oops. Alright, that's it for down here. Down that area anyway. What? Did you find something? Trying this door. Man's voice says, "Get up! Give it up, will you? It's not that I have no interest in refining rare metal. I have no intention to negotiate with people who don't introduce themselves. Please leave." Huh. Didn't introduce themselves. There's a man in a mask. He says nothing. The man in the mask kept staring at Avon with cold eyes. Oh! A trio of them. Huh. Who were they? Miles says, "I don't want to judge people by their appearance, but they didn't look like they were honest people." They ran off this way. Maybe they ran up here? No sign of them. Well, let's try to go in the door again. Plant Manager Castle says, "Can't you give up? How many times do I have to tell you? Guia's factory can't work with people who don't tell us who they are. We're gonna tell you who we are. Says Avon. Oh, I'm sorry. I thought they came back. We're friends of Rouca's. They told us he would be here, so we came to say hello. I see. Wait, are you Avon and Mile by any chance? Yes, we are, says Mile. How did you know our names? Rouca told me about you. Please have seats and make yourselves at home. Where? I don't see any seats. You helped him in Boren, right? Thank you very much. We didn't do much, says Avon. Where is Rouca, by the way? He is running an errand for me. He should be back soon, so please wait in this room. I have some bookkeeping to do. I apologize I won't be able to entertain you. You look busy, says Mile. We're short of people. Everyone has tons of things to do. Oh, I forgot. I must check the blast furnaces, too. I must do the checks before bookkeeping. May we help you? Says Avon. We can't just sit here waiting for Rouca. I can't impose. You're our guests. So polite. Mile says, we don't have the brain to do the bookkeeping, but is it difficult to check the blast furnaces? Not really. You just need to ask the workers operating each blast furnace if anything is wrong. Well, could you do that for me? It's a piece of cake, says Avon. Mile says, we just have to check with the workers operating each blast furnace, right? There are 5 blast furnaces, from number 1 to 5. Come back after you've gathered the workers' reports on all units. I owe you one. Thank you. I'll leave you with the blast furnace checks then. We're looking for an extra hand who can keep books, too. We don't ask for a great talent. We just need someone who works hard. Alright, well, we're still looking around, so... We got another rebleef. We'll check on these workers up here, and then we'll look around the... I guess the east side of the furnace. Because there's one here, and then there's one up north of here. And I think that's the only 2 workers we've seen? Working the furnaces anyway. Hi there. May I help you? Avon says, the plant manager sent us here to check on the blast furnaces. Oh, really? Thank you. The plant manager is a busy man. You're helping him a great deal. No problem with blast furnace 1. And then the other guy's up here. Whew! I'm drowning in sweat. The blast furnace is a delicate piece of equipment. We must check it frequently. Hello, says Mile. The plant manager sent us here. Is the blast furnace working all right? It's working great. All my sweat paid off. No problem with blast furnace 2. Now, there's another guy down here, but I don't remember him operating a blast furnace. I think? No. I don't see another guy. Never mind. Let's check. Through here, there was nobody. Yeah. That's the plant manager's office. Oh, I guess we're full of rebleef. I wonder if we're gonna have to do anything in these rooms, these utility rooms, whatever they are. Oh, the guy up here. That's right. There was 2 down there where we were, and then 1 here. It's so difficult to operate this blast furnace. Complex. Miles says, how is it different from other blast furnaces? This blast furnace is called the HFI. It's a new furnace developed to refine metals that melt at higher temperatures than iron. Output is higher, but handling is more difficult. Usually a young man named Rouca is looking after this furnace. Wow, says Avon. Rouca must be really good. He is in charge of such an advanced blast furnace. Well, he is our favorite pupil. By the way, what are you doing here? Miles says, the plant manager sent us a check on the blast furnaces. Oh, really? Thank you for doing it in this heat. Blast Furnace 5, HFI, is working normally. Rouca is smart and hardworking. He should become a skilled engineer in the future. Okay. And then up here is nothing. We can bonk our heads around. Okay, so up here we have not been. Hey, hey, don't come too close, or you'll get hurt. If you touch the furnace, burns will be the only consequence, or won't be the only consequence you'll suffer. We know, says Avon. We're not kids anymore. Miles says, the plant manager asked us to check on the blast furnaces. Oh, I see. No problem with blast furnace 3. I said, no problem, damn you. We got a little perch up here. There's the last guy. He's not looking after a furnace. Rouca says, there's an iron mine ahead. It's dangerous, so you can't go any further. Okay. Oops. You're full of rebleef. Okay, so that's it, really. Other than the mine where he says we can't go in. I have a feeling we'll be going in there soon, though. This red molten metal is so beautiful, I become spellbound just looking at it. Don't you feel the same? Avon says, I don't get spellbound, but I do feel it has a mysterious color. By the way, the plant manager sent us to check on the blast furnaces. Do you have any problem? Blast Furnace 4 is working fine so far. If something is wrong, the color of the liquid will change. Okay. Let's report back to the plant manager. That was easy enough. Plant manager, we checked all blast furnaces. None of them had a problem. Someone standing at the desk, though. Oh, thank you. We were just talking about you. Is that Rouca? Yeah, Rouca says, Avon, Mile, thank you for coming all the way to see me. You're back, Rouca, says Avon. Mile says, it's been a while. You look good. Aw, friends. Rouca says, I heard about your feat at the Eden Festival. You had a brilliant victory in the water match, didn't you, Avon? Congratulations. Well, that victory was just a luck. Just a luck. By the way, have you found your sister, Rouca? No. I have looked everywhere after we parted. It's not easy to find her. You know what this face reminds me of? Will I take a drink? What's that group? That, can't remember the name. It is Gorillaz from the Clint Eastwood song. It looks like the monkey face looking guy from the Gorillaz group, band, whatever. I have looked everywhere after we parted. It's not easy to find her. How about you, Avon? Same here. We did find a clue, but then we had to go back to the starting point. Avon explained to Rouca and the plant manager about what they had learned at the monastery. So Imel left there alone, Rouca says. It may be her, then. Do you know anything? Asks Avon. I heard a rumor in the tavern the other day. A traveler from Beloa passed by a girl with beautiful red hair on the highway. Really? Mile asks, was she heading for Beloa? No, she was traveling to Karuna Village. Karuna Village, says Avon. The plant manager says, it's a village in the north. It's known for intense cold. It's not widely known, but they have a chapel that enshrines spirit god Durga. Durga, yells Avon. Miles says, it makes sense. Emel is called Durga's daughter. The place may have something to do with what's happening to her. Rouca says, so do you think the girl is Emel? Miles says, I can't say for sure, but there's a high possibility. Avon, we should hurry. I agree, says Avon. Rouca, thank you for telling that to us. We'll leave for Karuna village right away. Once we find Emel, we'll come back to thank you. I understood. Oh, understood. I hope the girl was Emel. Plant manager says, be careful on your way. The girl with red hair reportedly left for a Karuna village. I hope it's Emel. Karuna. It's a cold place, but they have succulent seafood. If you're going there, you must try it. Sounds good to me. Well, what about that other village that nearby? Or town, whatever? Something's gonna happen. We're just... The furnaces are gonna start going insane when we try to leave here. I know it. The control unit used for this furnace must be worn quite heavily by now. It's time to replace it. Rouca was also saying the same thing. Oh boy. They're gonna blow! Well, I'll have a drink once I finish my work. Yeah, something's going on. They're all saying new things. By the way, I saw strange-looking men earlier. I wonder if they don't feel hot wearing such clothes. Around here, they probably do. They want the rare metal, I think. If the furnace temperature is too high, the liquid becomes whitish. If the temperature is too low, it becomes dark red. Orange color like this represents an optimal temperature. Okay. So I'll talk to the last guy here before. You don't need that. Was he through here, I think? Yeah, up here. A disaster will occur if this blast furnace malfunctions. We must tune them carefully. Okay. I think we're all doomed. Okay. Enact cutscene. Now. No? Oh. Really? I swear something was gonna happen. I saw Rouca going into the factory just now. Did you see him? Yes, we did. Thank you. Who are the guys in masks visiting the plant manager? They are really suspicious. Well, you're the gatekeeper. You should know all these things, shouldn't you? Hey, Avon. Oh, it's Giamane. Have you seen my rider? Hi, Giamane. Are you looking for him again? I feel sorry for you, says Mile. Thanks. I'm so distressed. He began writing a new book, Quick Raven, after hearing about your story, but he still has this habit of running away from me. He disappears every time he runs out of ideas. Worries are bad for the skin, you know? I'm going crazy. Hey, calm down, says Avon. If we find him, we'll tell him stories he may be able to use in his book. Really? Can you do that? Well, we have been doing that. Thank you so much. I know I can count on you, Avon. I love you too, Mile. Mile says, haha, thanks for remembering me. All right, then. If you can find him, please take care of him, will you? Oh, I almost forgot. This is for the other day. It's Quick Raven Volume 2. Sweet. Promise me you will read it. I'm sure I'll become a million seller. We got it. So you read through it really quick. Let you guys know, once I find all the volumes, I'll be putting up book videos of them, as well as the Swordmaster books. Quick Raven Volume 2, A Change of Plans, Karamuro Karamas. They're here. Raven sent a signal to his partner behind him. When he concentrated, he heard voices of men from deeper in the cavern. All we have to do is give this to him, then we're all done. Yeah, that was easy, but I wonder why he wants an old book like this. Don't you know, this book is... Suddenly, the voices became inaudible. The owner's voice was probably whispering for effect, but that yielded unexpected results. Crunch? Oh no! As Raven tried to step closer to hear what was being said, he mistakenly scraped his feet on the ground. Who's there? The men yelled in response. Raven shrugged and signaled tomorrow. Change of plans. He didn't have any plans to begin with. Without hesitation, the two simultaneously ran to the direction of the voices. What the heck? The area they jumped into was smaller than expected. Five men were drawing their own weapon against the intruders. They dressed and looked like stereotypical thieves. Raven and Marl were already moving before the men understood what was going on. Well, it's pretty short. Alright, let's see if we can find the writer. Can't believe this. Where is he gone? Please take care of him, will you? Well, sometimes he stays at inns. Sound of someone gulping down liquid. Fah! Ha! I live to drink tasty cold ones. It tastes great, especially when I had to skip my lectures to get it. Lectures? Says Avon. Skipped? Says Mile. Oops! Please forget what you just heard. Heck, it's a fine day. It's a waste of life to sit around in a room and listen to a stupid lecture on such a beautiful day. My students are lucky to have an understanding teacher like me. Heck! Avon says, you don't sound convincing saying that in here. Is this your first time in Guia? I come here to place steel orders. Yeah, I read that. I read that. Let's see if what's his name is down here. Karamuro. Always hiding from that GME. Not that I blame him. Yeah, let's get a room. Night night. And they're back on the run. With their cat fetching things they do not need. We met your husband. My husband is in charge of the factory. Many single men work there, so I keep myself fairly busy introducing girls to them. Okay. Gotta find that Karamas. I thought I saw something up there. Guess we don't want any jobs. I read that before. Thank you. Alright. Not seeing anything new and not finding Karamas. Oops. Last time he was down somewhere around here? No. Wait a second. Yeah, he was down here. Don't see him now. Alright. Where could he be hiding? Oh, someone in there now. She's back. Knock, knock, knock. I want to speak with you. The old lady living next door came back, but something is wrong with her. She doesn't say a word after seeing me. Usually she showers me with those hateful words. He misses that, doesn't he? I wonder if Rayo has finally gone senile. No. It can't be. How can that nagging old woman become senile so easily? The mind is a strange thing. Rayo seems to have returned from the pilgrimage to the Holy Capital. But it's funny, was Vault so close that she could come back so quickly? How do you say that? Vault? Valked? We still can't get in their house. I wonder if there's we can find a way in. Yeah, heard that. She's not only bored, but she's boring, because she doesn't say anything new. Engineer Dalton says the control unit of the furnace is pretty old. That's why we're doing inspection frequently. However, it's probably time we consider replacing it with a new unit. Why don't I ask Ruka's opinion? Why don't you? We're looking around for this Karamas. Orders have increased notably of late. We can't carry out enough steel in time for shipment. We must hurry. I'm getting nervous. Well then, get to it. Stop sitting around in there. Fun to cook for someone. Let's see, what shall I cook for tonight? Well, who would be him? What is not what for, but... Iron ore productions are decreasing lately. Guia mine is like a mountain made of iron ores, but we have been digging for quite some time now. Iron ores may be running out. Eerie-looking guys are coming in and out of town lately. What are they here for? I'm a little worried. Yeah, something's gonna happen. I'm just not sure what triggers it. I guess I was trying to leave town or something. We don't have time going back to New Borin, says Avon. So where is this guy? Maybe he's down in the production area again. Maybe we have to go back down there. Not that he's down there again, but we have to go down there again. Let's check down there again for Karamus. Passing through. I don't think he would. Not here, but maybe, yeah, in the factory area is what I meant. Which is not this. Maybe he's hiding out in one of those rooms. That's a good idea. They moved over. But they're not saying anything new. Karamus or anyone at all, really. Let's just look up here. That. All iron ores using Korea's foundry are produced in this mine. We have been digging for quite some time, so the iron veins are depleting. I wonder what we'll do when the mine is out of iron ores. Oh, he says that thing again. Where is Karamus? We can't be moving on from Guia so quickly. There's gotta be something coming up, right? West is Baloa. And then Karuna Sorcery School. Avon says, is this the correct way to Karuna Village? We should check just to be safe, says Mile. Doesn't mention it. Oh, it does. Baloa, Karuna Sorcery School? I guess we're right. We must turn north along the way to Baloa. Alright then, let's go. I found you, says a girl's voice. Huh. Josie says, you wearing a red bandana and you with golden hair. You must be Avon and Mile. How did you know our name, says Mile. I have a letter for you. It's from a girl named Amel. What, says Mile. From Amel, says Avon. Here it is. Avon was given a Mel note. Goodbye.